Good morning all. So today we are going to start with the next unit. The next unit is the tires and the specification. So in the previous unit that we actually discussed about the steady state cornering, but in this unit we are going to discuss related to the tires and how it affects during braking, during acceleration, as well as what are the various characteristics of the tires. So the syllabus you are able to see here, that is the syllabus as per our LPU syllabus. That is the topic is the ride characteristic of the tires. Then effect of the driving torque, effect of the braking torque, and the finally is the rough, this is GURF's tires characteristic. So these topics we are going to cover the lecture to lecture. Now coming to the basic first, what is basically a tire, what are the various classification of the tires, what is the primary function of the tires. So we will discuss it. So you are able to see one figure. That figure basically showcases a different terminology is related to the tire. That means the top surface basically representing here is the running surface. Then there is a side face with the extreme condition that representing the shoulder. Then this is representing a belt, individual belt basically having a different steel wires and the fabrics. There is an intermediate layer, that means a layer between the lower as well as the upper bound. Between layer is representing the intermediate ply. Carcass is basically, again it is a layer, or we can say high tensile strength layer is there, having some chord angle that actually used here. We are going to discuss this. This is representing a side wall. This is a bead reinforcement, that means in between we actually filling some reinforcement just to increase the strength of the tire. This is a bead core again, and inner one is representing the interior insulating layer. So these all are representing as the terminologies related to the tire. Now coming to the tire introduction, so what are the basic functions of the tire? So you can see here, the first function of the tire is it acts as a primary suspension. That means there is a cushioning effect will be there, as well as it works very smooth on the rough surface. Second function of the tire, that means it provides some frictional contact between the road and the surface. This is the second primary function we can say here. The next one is it allows a driving wheel to move the vehicle. That means if the vehicle doesn't produce any kind of frictional force, that is, it is not able to move over the surface. So that means it allows the driving wheel to move the vehicle. So that is actually moving the vehicle because of the traction force. So when the traction force basically acts due to the frictional effect or frictional force effect. And the next one, the front tire allows the wheel to steer. This is also another function while during a cornering effect. Front tire allows wheel just to taking a turn. And the last one, it allows to slow down the vehicle during a braking or due to the retardation. So this is again another function. So apart from this, what are the essential three basic functions of the tire? So the first is it supports a vertical load. That means this basic function basically representing in terms of load. So what are the various forces actually acting on the system? The first force, it supports a vertical load. Vertical load means the weight of the vehicle, including passengers, including the cargo, while cushioning against the rock, that is the road shocks. And the second one, it develops a longitudinal force while acceleration and during braking conditions. So that means during the running condition, you already know the what type of force basically acting, that we already discussed in the previous unit. So go refer or do refer the same in details. And the last one, it also develops some lateral forces during cornering. So we already discussed in the previous unit the lateral forces, that is represented by a symbol Fy. Fy actually correlate with the symbol slip angle, with the constant cornering stiffness. We have already discussed this. So that means these three are the common forces that actually act while we can say while vehicle is in dynamic. That means when the vehicle actually moves over the surface. So vertical load, then longitudinal force, and the lateral forces. Now coming to the next. So first of all, what is actually a tire? Tire is nothing, it is just a simple viscoelastic toroid. The toroid basically representing here is nothing, it is a circular cross-section member which is actually refined with some specific rubber material with some reinforcement. So with the help of this rubber material, rubber again it is not the natural rubber, this is a combination of natural and the synthetic rubber that actually used to making a simple viscoelastic material. That simple viscoelastic material that has been molded in terms of tire that basically we use. So when we talking about the optimizing the property that has been used in a tire, it is very difficult to identify or it is very difficult to quantify that property. So what we basically do, we use some sets of empirical formulas. So that sets of empirical formulas basically we use to justify that values which is near about. We cannot say it is the exact value, but it is the near about value. Second one, we actually considered as a tire as a mechanical structure, because you already know the tire basically having a very common property, that is elastic property. So due to that elastic property, it is actually made because of the some carcass. So because of that carcass, a high tensile strength has been produced in the tire. So how we actually get the high tensile strength over the tire? That is basically we use some reinforcement. So some very common type of reinforcement basically we use are steel cables. Steel cable basically it is actually we can say the molded, or it is actually embedded inside the rubber material. So that becomes a single material actually having a more strength. So that is the a mechanical structure. And the last one, what effect if the pressure is lesser? So you can read this, the internal pressure, that means the internal inflation creates some stresses, that means the structure in basically it behaves like that. If any extra force or any external force basically causing some deformation in a carcass results in the tire reaction force. That means if any extra force or any external force actually creating some distortion or deformation over the tire, so that carcass basically results in some reaction force actually acting in a different manner. That means magnitude will be the same, but it actually acting in a opposite direction, because this is just a reaction force is there. Now next, talking about the tire construction. So what are the various classifications of the tire? So very common, the tire is actually of two type, either it is a bias tire, either it is a radial tire, or in other term we can say it is a bias ply tire or the radial ply tire. So here if we talking about the bias ply tire is also known as a cross ply tire. Cross ply means because it is actually diagonally, we actually using some plies one over the another at different orientation. So because of that orientation, that is also known as a cross ply tires, or in common term it is also known as a bias ply tires. So if you see the bias ply tire, it was the standard used in American automotive industries from the 1960s. So that means the advantage of that tire is previously it was very good in nature, but due to the introduction of the radial tire, that this bias is not we can say it is nowadays it is also using, but it is actually preferred by, that means the radial tire is actually most of them preferred by the industries, because there is a more advantage. That means the stiffness of the tire, that means the radial one is much higher as compared to the bias one. So this is the bias tire. Now coming to the radial ply tire. So what is a radial ply tire? Radial ply tire, nothing, it is just a plies basically we use one over the other. What is the ply? Ply is nothing, it is just a rubberized material that is actually reinforced with the some nylons, cords, either the rayon or polyester or the different fiberglasses are there. So these cord actually, we can say not cord, these plies are actually arranged one over the other in a parallel manner, so that actually representing is a radial in a radial construction. So what is the angle at we actually doing this? It is actually connected at an angle of 90 degree angle to the circumference. That means the arrangement of that plies actually it is a 90 degree to the circumference. Next, the plies are actually referred as a carcass that we actually discussed, or we have already seen in the previous figure. This carcass is nothing, it is just a representing a member basically we use that is actually more flexible at the sidewall. So due to that carcass, the material becomes more flexible at the sidewall, and or we can say the stability of the vehicle becomes good. So how to talking other, suppose if I'm talking about the directional stability, there is very lesser, or we can say a negligible directional stability will be there. So how to increase the directional stability in the radial tire? Very common thing, you can increase the directional stability by introducing a stiff belt of fabric or the steel wire. So that means if we using a steel wire or the stiff belt in the radial tire, the function of that stiff belt and the steel wire is basically to increase the directional stability. That means while cornering, you feel very smooth, and while taking a turn, the balancing of force will be much better as compared to the without using the stiff belt. So this is the advantage of using stiff belt. Now coming to the next, in the same, so what type of chord angle basically we use in a radial ply tire? If we, you can see here, the chord angle basically we use within a range of 20 degree of the treads. So this is a very common angle basically we use. If we talking about a bias ply, the angle basically they prefer 35 degree to 55 degree. That means very high chord angle they actually considered. So because of that one, this can be the disadvantage for the radial one. This can be the advantage because of using a lesser chord angle, it creates some stabilize effect. What is the stabilize effect? That means if you're talking about while cornering or while taking a turn, this belt basically stabilize. Reason being, due to that lesser degree of the chord angle, the tire becomes flat in nature instead of creating some extra lateral forces. Sorry. So because of that lateral forces, there is some unbalanced force can be created. So how to avoid this lateral forces? We can actually using a less chord angle. So because of that less chord angle, the system becomes more stabilized or the tire becomes more stabilized while taking a turn. So very common type of radial tire, they actually use a 2-ply fabric sidewalls, or either they can use a 2 steel belts or the 2 to 6 fabric belts, depending upon the requirement, depending upon the load condition. So this is the complete radial ply tire. Now coming to the bias ply. Bias ply is actually quite common, is like a radial ply, but a different construction criteria, different specification criteria in terms of arrangement. In a bias ply, the carcass is actually basically made of two or more plies extended from bead to bead. That means it is representing here again one ply over the other ply. We actually arranging in a different manner, but actually having a high chord angle that I already told initially, from 35 degree to 40 degree. Sometimes we consider also 50 degree. Due to that high tread angle, it creates some kind of directional stability. That means it is not a stability, directional instability we can say. So here we generally preferred low chord angle instead of using a high chord angle. So read this: high angle resultant tire which are soft for ride comfort, but low angle are best suitable for the directional stability. If we are using a high chord angle, the stability during cornering will not be there, but at these straight path, maybe it is a very soft, or we can say the ride comfort will be good in nature. So we generally preferred a low cost, or that means a low, sorry, low angle based directional stability. So bias ply basically having, again, it creates some much stiffness as compared to the radial one, but in which direction? It is in the lateral direction. So this is the advantage of the bias ply tire. If we using a bias ply, the lateral balancing is much better as compared to the radial tire while cornering, as well as the bias ply allow the tread to roll under as well. That means it is representing here while taking a turn, the outer ribs actually create, actually having a more load. That means bearing some more load as compared to the inner rib. So this is a bias ply carcass property. The construction of that one is actually creating some more distortion, so that's why it is actually very lesser used nowadays. Company preferred radial tire because the strength of the radial tire is much higher as compared to the bias ply tire. Reason being, there's a one more disadvantage of the bias tire: the distortion is very high while rolling. While rolling means when the vehicle actually start moving in that situation, so some twisting actually going on. So at the contact path means where the tire and the ground surface is actually matched, there's a toroid deform. Toroid deform is nothing, it is representing the twisting deform in the into a flat shape. That it becomes a flattened in nature. Due to that flattened in nature, the tread to twist in a, again it is a squirm is representing here. That means there is a directional twisting will be going on in the contact patch when rolling. So due to that one, the distortion is much higher in the bias tire. So you are able to see here the two figure that representing here the bias tire, upper one representing a tread, or we can say is the surface of the tire, rolling surface of the tire. Again, this is for the radial ply. You can see this ply, it is actually 90 degree to the circumferential, that is a nominal angle. Then after we actually use a different carcass plies, one ply, that means a belt, we can say one belt over the another belt. That means it is a bead to bead we actually using here. Angle is very lesser as compared to this one. You can see here the angle is actually very high, or that angle, one angle, that means a ply actually having angle suppose 35 to 40 degree, other ply actually in opposite direction we actually use. That means alternate direction we use to arrange the plies. So this is the figure or schematic you are able to see for the tire. Now coming to the same for the cross ply tire or the bias tire. So basically we actually not using for the mass production. However, the construction of these tires depends on the technology developed. That means nowadays we use a tubeless tire instead of using a bias one. So several textile plies are laid across each other running from bead to bead in alternate direction. So due to that one, so this is actually presenting here the arrangement of the tire. The number of plies again depends upon the load carrying capacity of the tire, depends on the vehicle, depends on the cargo weight. So these are the functions. So there is a one more term is very common here, that is a crown. So number of plies basically we use, it is also used in a crown. Crown basically we use in between the tread and the surface. So this is actually a term we actually use also. Next, in the radial tire, the ply consists of carcass formed by a textile arc running from one wheel to another wheel. We already discussed this. What is the angle of that ply? 90 degree to the circumferential direction. At the top surface of the crown, we already discussed this. What is crown? Crown basically representing here under the tread. That means under the tread, what are the surface basically we have? That is representing a tire crown. So there is a belt made up of several plies reinforced with the metal wires laid on the top of the carcass. Carcass ply over which we actually using some belt. So that means if we see upper portion representing a tread, then go downside, that is representing a crown, then go downside, you are able to see the number of belts, then the last one that is representing a carcass. So this is the arrangement of that radial ply tire. Now coming to the tire specification, how to read the tire. That means you have already seen the numerous tires where some codings you are able to see, that is written in this the same manner, like P205-55VR16. What is the meaning of that one? So what is the first term? The P basically representing here is the type of the vehicle. That means it is a passenger vehicle, it is a temporary vehicle, it is a light truck or the commercial vehicle. So with the because of that specific thing, that symbol has to be used. So this is I am talking about for the four-wheel drive or the four-wheelers. This P representing for the passenger car. Now coming for the second one, 205 is nothing, it is representing as the width. So width of the tire basically it is in the range from 145 to 315. So that means it is representing as the width of the tire is 205 mm. Next one, 55, basically representing as the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio, that means it is a ratio of height to the width in terms of percentage. So it can be used 55, 60, 65, 70, 90, 80. So that means we can use aspect ratio, height to the width in percentage. Next one, it is the V. So V basically representing here is the speed, where the speed representing here V or capital B or Z. So that is at a different speed, we can use that speed rating. And finally, R representing for the radial tire, or B representing for the bias belted, and D representing for bias ply tire. So different types of tire basically we can use, and 16 representing as the rim diameter. That means what is the rim diameter? That is in terms of inch, 13, 14, 16, 15, so that we actually using. So same case, if you're talking about for the two wheelers, you are able to see this type of coding has been showcased. That is 140/60-R17. So the meaning of that one is representing here. What is the first term? It is representing here the width of the tire, 60 representing the aspect ratio, R17 representing here is the, read this, 110 representing the tire width, 90 representing the tire height, that means as per the width, that means it is representing aspect ratio, and 18 representing the rim diameter. Same manner here, R representing for the radial one and 17 representing for the size of the tire, that means in terms of inch, either it is a 17 inch, 18 inch, and like this. So we will continue our lecture based on what are the various mechanisms has been used. So we will discuss in the next lecture. If any doubt, then please let me know. Thank you.